Salut, banane chantante. Sorry, hi, singing banana. This is Wahid. I'm talking to you from MIT in Cambridge, Massachusetts. I'm attending an event called the MIT Chairman Salon. And I am the publisher of a French language website called legardien.wordpress.com. And I have a question for you on behalf of our readers, which is this. Who is your favorite French mathematician?
Salut to you too. It's a great question and thanks for asking, but it's a difficult question for me to answer because France has a long tradition of brilliant mathematicians, and to pick one seems almost unfair, but some names I could have picked, some names you may have heard of before. Poincaré. Poincaré couldn't tell the difference between a coffee mug and a donut and was subsequently fired from his job at Starbucks. Descartes was a mathematician and a philosopher, or at least he thought he was. Galois, another great mathematician, lousy shot. But the guy I want to nominate, the guy I'm going to nominate today, is this guy. This is Blaise Pascal. Now, you may have heard of Pascal's triangle before, which counts combinations. If you're an engineer, you may have heard of his work on fluids and pressure. He argued that empirical evidence is not enough to establish major truths, and he made further contributions to the axiomatic system of mathematics. But the reason I want to nominate him today is for his work on probability, which established a whole new branch of mathematics. Now, some pieces of biographical information. Blaise here was born in 1623 and he lived in Paris. He wrote his first serious work on geometry at the age of 16, but he was dismissed for being precocious. At the age of 18, he designed a mechanical calculator, which was very expensive, but was something of a status symbol in France and across Europe at the time. In sciences, he predicted the existence of a vacuum. This was at a time when they thought that nature abhorred a vacuum. They thought it didn't exist. And this brought him into conflict with some other scientists of the time, people like Descartes. But he wasn't just a scientist. He was a writer and theologian too, and is considered to be one of the great French authors. Now, never a well man, he died in 1662 at the age of 39. However, in 1654, a friend of his called the Chevalier de Mer posed a question to him and to Fermat, another great mathematician with a small notebook. Two players play a game. Let's call them Pascal and Fermat. Now, this game involves flipping a coin. If the coin comes up heads, Pascal gets a point. If it comes up tails, Fermat gets the point. Each player bets 3,000 francs, making a total pot of 6,000 francs. The first to get 10 points wins. So it's a game, it's a best of 19. And they will win the whole pot, the whole 6,000 francs. Now, Pascal is winning. He's winning 8-7. So he only needs 2 more points to win the game. When Fermat receives an urgent message and he must leave immediately, he doesn't even have time to finish his last proof. Now, how should the pot be divided up? Well, historically, the answer would have been to divide the pot in proportion to the number of games already won. So if Pascal is winning 8-7, then Pascal would win 3,200 francs compared to 2,800 francs. But this leads to problems, such as if the two players had only played one game before being interrupted, then the winner of that game would take the whole pot, which hardly seems fair when you've got 18 games left to play. So let's consider the next 4 games. And this is the solution that Pascal and Fermat came up with. Now, there are 16 equally likely outcomes. If we indicate the games where Pascal would have won, you can see that Pascal would have won 11 of them and Fermat would have won the remaining five. So let's divide the pot in that proportion of the number of games they would have won. That would mean that Fermat wins 1,875 francs, and the winner is Pascal with 4,125 francs. Now, before Pascal and Fermat, there was no theory of probability. There were some vague ideas, but it was these two who began to make it a coherent whole. And together, they laid the foundations of modern probability theory. And that's my nomination. So that's it for now. So I guess, see you later, calculator.